I was on the grind, they was caught up in the hype. Now you niggas ain't shining like you used to. Page 25, I'm caught the ill ride that my daddy do when I was still in high school.
So, this is your moderator, Mr. Holani. He is a senior environmental health practitioner from City of. Maybe some of you are familiar with him. You have seen him when you were doing work integrated learning. Anyone familiar with him? Okay, where did you see him? Where did you see him? You said you're familiar with him. What is your name?
Tomahan.
Yes, where did you see him? Yeah, that's where he's working, eh? That's where he's working. So he's the moderator for the module, but he is a very involved moderator. So he is going to be doing some of the lectures as well, in my absence or even when I'm here. So he's a very experienced gentleman. He will tell you about himself, where he started. But he's a UJ alumni. He studied here, just like you guys. He's my master's graduate. So he knows how strict I am. He knows how strict I am. So he's just waiting for me to finalize the PhD, and then he can come and do his PhD. Then I will supervise him. Yeah. So we grow together in environmental health. Yeah. Yeah. So Mr. Holani, I'm going to have a seat and give you the opportunity to take us through the lecture. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Mukwat. Afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. How are you? I'm good, thanks. So what she forgot to mention is that we've known each other for close to that 21 years, ne?
Almost, yeah.
Yeah, close to that 21 years, because she's the reason I did environmental health. So she's the reason. So her mother and my mother are friends. Worked at the same hospital. Then it just so happens, out to you, someone graduates, then a year or two later, Mutusa driver for law. And back then it was like, what the? So then I had to find out, Origante, what course did you do? How did you win when it comes to this life thing? Then she told me environmental health. I did my research a bit. Oh, environmental health, almost failed grade 11, if I remember correctly, but made it into matric, qualified for environmental health. Then the HOD at the time, Mr. Shikwamban, who's a deputy director now at the City of Johannesburg Metro Center, he's the one that was like, Haumuna, you say you applied, we called you for an interview and you didn't come through for the interview. Why? I'm like, you guys didn't call me. He insisted and told me now there's no more space. It's full for that year. Then I asked for his number and I badgered him with calls every single day because it was still January. So I still had a chance to go in, or so I believed. Then he called me and said, okay, since you're busy pestering me, pull through on Monday. This was a Friday. Come through on Monday, let's see what we can do. Power of anticipation and planning, I anticipated that this is probably where my interview is going to happen. So I just prepared over the weekend, came through, and indeed, he greeted me and said, in that office over there, Ms. Hammond and Ms. Swanepoel are waiting for you. The interview happened, and it was just tick, tick. You know Nikemus. Tick, 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 tick. Then I was in. Then I made a promise to him that very day that he actually said, you are allowed to come through and study environmental health. It was 2007. And I was like, you know what? I almost failed grade 11. I just squeezed myself in here, but I'm gonna get a distinction for every subject just because you allowed me in. He was like, hey, Baba, don't put too much pressure on yourself. You are welcome, good luck. I said, every year, at the end of the year, I'm gonna come back to you and show you my results. Obviously, as an HOD, you sign them off, you know? Especially the highest student in the class, they're gonna be signed off. And indeed, words have power. So every year, at the end of the year, I went, showed him my result, everything distinction. Did you guys do anatomy and physiology? I think that was my highest mark for first year. I think it was around 1992, somewhere there. Microbiology, you did that? That was my second highest. I think it was 89. For someone who almost failed maths and science, grade 11, those were my marks. And everything else, I think my lowest for first year was like 85 or something like that. Then second year happened again, went to him. Then third year, he left. At the end of the year, I came, luckily he just came through coincidentally when I came to fetch my final results. Because back then it was a 3-year course. Then he came through, I showed him my results. He's like, I'm fanaka, cum laude. I'm like, go ready. So that's the first lesson, guys. Words have power. So however prepared you are for this year, if you remember anything that came out from my mouth, remember that. Words have power. Now let's get into all about me, just some more, since I've already introduced a bit of myself, right? And also, since Mem Kwatle has also given you some highlights in terms of who I am. So I am a master's graduate under Ms. Mukwatle's supervision. She keeps lying to herself, thinking the reason I'm not doing it is because I'm waiting for her. Kanti, no, it's my own reasons. But from today, she knows the truth, right? So my PhD is coming. I'm not in a hurry, but it is coming. I'm a lecturer, as she's already told you guys. I've been a moderator for the module since 2017, if not 2016. But I only started lecturing during COVID. So when were you? You were what, first year, second year?
First year.
That was the first time I started actually lecturing the module. When I was a moderator, I would just come in as a guest speaker or a guest presenter, guest lecturer. So I'll also bring some of my friends who are in the industry doing different things based on what they are delving in, so that you don't just get that one-dimensional experience of a lecturer, but you get to know what happens in the municipalities, what happens at district level, province, what happens if you were to go the route of opening your own business, right? So I'm the CEO, which is an environmental health business. It's turning 6 years old next week. We have a small team of 4 people and 1 environmental health graduate. You know, when I say this thing is to encourage you to make sure you don't think one-dimensionally when you enter the profession. Granted, business is not easy. It's not. So one of the best things you can do for yourself is to actually pass and to pass well. Differentiate yourself from everybody else. Then delve into that arena knowing that you've done your best and you've prepared for what you've set yourself into. Because it takes 5 years just for a business to say, I've survived. After 5 years, so you already know, since Rena 6 years, things are communicating, the combos are communicating. So from a business standpoint, is our business. I delve into a lot of things. So 13 years in the profession since my COMSEV, 2010 I did my COMSEV, got the World Cup, I was at Port Health or Tambo International Airport. That was me, first time. Fortunately, I've never been unemployed. But obviously the results, who you network with, who you know, they all play a role. So get to know her, get to know me, and we move forward. Ask last year's guys how many calls I get. EnviroSwitch Cares Foundation is a foundation of ours, which is a nonprofit organization. This is where now, if there's extra funds that the business generates, that can go towards helping students, contributing towards universities, helping those in need, orphanages. Back in 2019, we donated like 600 shoes in Newcastle, in KZN, to a primary school. So that's one of the things that gives me pride, to say everything is actually beyond the profession. It's all about the purpose, live a purpose-driven life. Right, then I'm a senior environmental health practitioner. I should have started with that. Ne? I'm a senior environmental health practitioner, city of. I actually do remember her. I took her out for lunch with another student. You were two.
And she doesn't say.
Yeah. We went to Spur and it was their last day. And, you know, they enjoyed and that was that, you know. And they had non-alcoholic beverages. And then my most important mission in life is that I'm a father and a husband. Been married since 2013, met her concept, 2010.
So he's married to an EHP.
I'm married to an EHP, so don't believe what they tell you. The stories around, hey, we talk about our own conversation.
And I'm not married to an EHP.
Funny. So that's my most important mission in life. I have two girls. Two girls, if the Lord blesses me with one more, I'm China, I'll still be happy. Like one, I'll still be happy. But yeah, it's my greatest mission in life. And then I'm also a life coach, a mentor, and a YouTuber. Currently have around 800 and something subscribers. Channel name, it starts with you, Network with Less. It starts with you, Network with Less. That's the channel name. Eh? So if you want life advice, career advice, mentorship, because there's always the concept of university being one-dimensional or considered to be one-dimensional. But when you delve into what life is all about, then that's where you get to explore all these things. I also do things that are money-related, which is very important when it comes to you guys coming straight from tertiary and entering that work life, to know that you don't just rush to buy that first car outside all the calculations.